U Datinu, Montenegro, Podgorica, u Datinu all listeners and attenders of GEO conference. I'm Dragan Perović, originally from Montenegro, and I'm happy because the organizers invited me to talk about work that I'm doing. On this case, I will talk about importance of plant genetic resources, especially wheat and barley, and methods of the utilization in this new genome sequencing era. I will talk a short about Julius Kuhn Institute in which I'm working, and also the Institute for Insulin-Resistant Research and Stress Tolerance. I will talk about barley and wheat genomic resources, especially about, let's say, the development in the sequencing technologies and how this was interpolated in the genomic resources of these two most important cereal crops. Then shortly about barley wheat genetic resources that we are using now, that we are facing, and we'll present data about our work when we are combining different molecular marker system in breed in the selection, let's say, of the subset of core collection, presenting the most divergent set of lines, and I will give a summary of all of this. About JKI, the motto of JKI is securing tomorrow's resources. It is a federal research center for cultivated plants constituted in 2008 as a branch of the German Ministry of Food and Agriculture. It consists of 70 specialized institutes plus several service units. Our tasks are policy advice, research, and scientific assessment. Major fields of our research are plant genetics, breeding research, then plant mathematician, agronomy and soil sciences, and plant protection and plant health. In the Julius Kuhn Institute, they are in many towns in cities in Germany, and headquarters is in Quedlinburg. Regarding Institute of Resistant Research and Stress Tolerance at Fedimin, which I'm working, nowadays we are having concentrated on improvement of resistance and tolerance to the biotic and biotic stresses to agricultural crops, especially to cereals, but also the land crop, arable crops. We can see from this screen molecular analysis combining all activities. On the left side, we can just see different stresses. We are working to different viruses, inactivated pays, for example, nematodes, then about fungi and bacteria, but also about abiotic stress. We are developing method for the assessment for resistance tolerance, then evaluating genetic resources, doing genetic analysis, for example, mapping our classical genetic and quantitative traits. Then we are doing structural analysis and resistance tolerance at the genome level, also the gene isolation, and developing our strategies and methods for studies assessment and respective resistance of tolerance in plant breeding. When we are talking about, let's say, the plant genomes of crop plants, we can just see that Arabidopsis first sequenced plant is very small, or rice almost 15 years ago have been sequenced, but only 2012-16 was really possible to establish, let's say, first drafts of this species, and only sequencing on, let's say, a small part of these genomes, because these genomes are 11 times or 30 times bigger than rice, our first crop plant that was sequenced. One major push to the sequencing development technology was developing and reducing the cost, and allowed actually the sequencing of these two large genomes, because a major obstacle was up to now, let's say, large proportion of repetitive DNA that is present in these two genomes. When we are talking about DNA sequencing technologies, it could be separated in three different groups. First generation, this is called Gilbert and Sanger sequencing. Then second generation was established 2008. Next generation sequencing, that was a short trees up to 300 bases usually, maybe sometimes up to 1 kb the last years, but this is so-called amplification based sequencing. And 2010 already developed called a third generation single molecule sequencing technologies without any amplification, that been up to now of less economical importance due to the high error rate, but I will show you some new development also in this technology. When talking about the quality and read length of sequencing technologies, it is very important that Illumina and Sanger having, let's say, sequences of up to 1 kb with almost 100% quality. Then 454 was really then much less, and the third generation sequencing packed by Nanopore very much longer reads its kilobases, but with many errors. Long read technology, but a major driver to lead to better genome contiguity and development of the in repetitive element rich regions, establishment of the so-called pseudomolecules on the DNA level. Because, as I mentioned, this addresses the problems of repetitive non-coding regions in the plant genome. And since 2 years, Balia did genome, first cultivars has been published, and let's say the collection of frontiers in plant science, we worked to show what kind of applications are now available, for example, in the breeding or in genetics or in biology. All scientists that are doing something with these two species, discovery, isolation of genes, allele mining, development of large-scale SFP genotype, implant integration of different other kind of data, GWAS and genomics prediction. One of the major drivers, or let's say outputs of the sequencing technology, was really improvement in marker throughput of molecular markers in barley and wheat. You can just see this scale from RFRP mark that we used more than 20 years ago, with a large amount, very expensive markers, 2012, first high throughput class from 9K, 9000 SNPs was developed, and really allowed, let's say, to zoom in and do the first genome-wide association analysis, something like that, in wheat online. In wheat, in parallel, is developed nowadays two major players. Actually, the high throughput platform has been majorly used in the breeding. Is a, let's say, GBS platform, genotype by sequencing, and 90,000K chip. These two technologies are very compatible because only a very small amount of markers being, let's say, in common. These are completely different regions in the genome, targeting even between GBS and, let's say, the sequence part of genes in wheat is only very, very small amount of SNPs are in common. For that reason, let's say, all these developments, marker development, usually, for example, in my institute, in different, five different projects, big genotypes, almost 900 different genotypes, and the new project that will be that is aiming to dissect, for example, nematodes. Our aim was really to select a set of most diverse genotypes and use this for the phenotyping, because nowadays the bottleneck usually is not the genotyping, more let's say the phenotyping, because large collection, thousand lines, could not be phenotyped. For that reason, for example, we accumulated data from 50K from 2011, 2012, up to 90K data with five different projects, and filtered this data for the minor allele frequency, then maximum percentage, maximum of heterozygous, then imputated this data and selected a set of 320 lines for further. Then selection of genetically diverse set, after all this that could be done by the, for example, CAM-Medoid, a small algorithm that could be used, but also the software that accompanying five different algorithms called Core Hunter. I mean, GenBank and many scientists are using this software, but our way was really to compare, let's say, these two platforms and methods, and how is looking our pipeline. Out of the 90,000 and 15,000 SNPs, we found almost 12,800 common markers between two platforms. Then we mapped them to the reference sequence of the weed. I found 9,800 are uniquely mapped. Then we did a removal of the missing values and all this stuff, and hetero high percent of heterozygosity. At the end, we found a set of 9,200 markers for the further analysis. When we are doing, for example, any genome-wide association study, we are combining genotypic data, phenotypic data, but for the, for example, genotypic data, we can use 9,000-2,000 markers. But, for example, very computing intensive stuff, population structural kinship calculation will take almost months for the calculating. Therefore, we have to do the subselection of set of most informative markers. This is about 2,300 markers, so this means only 1/4 of them. And we established, let's say, the relatedness of these genotypes between 800, almost 900 marked genotypes and 320 for selection. We can just see that HapMap is showing, let's say, high diversity of this. We can just see the principal component analysis of these selected lines from five collections. And then we compare, let's say, the performance between all these methods. We can just found the CAM-Medoids could find out most diverse set out of the large collections in performance much better than any of the, let's say, the from core set from the standard program that is used in GenBank software algorithm. And then we use, let's say, this set subset for the, let's say, the phenotyping with nematodes in our common project. In summary, advances in development of sequencing technology enabled accomplishment of reference genomes of barley and wheat and development of high-throughput molecular markers technologies. In the published collection of 18 articles at the Frontiers, you can just find out 18 articles covering, let's say, genome-wide association studies, genomic selection, mapping of major genes in the parental population, positional gene isolation, but also new marker development methods, detection of introgressions in the large collections from GBS data, and analysis of long coding RNAs. That is also the very important nowadays task for the scientists that are working on these two species. We identified CAM-Medoid method as the best method for the selecting small core set out of large collection genotype that could be used for the phenotyping. First, I would like to thank people from my working group at the ARES Institute, especially Bechmeister and Mani, postdoc in my group that worked on this CAM-Medoid method. I would like to thank people from SBA, bioinformaticians, then people from IPK, Gattersleben, GenBank. Then also I would like to thank colleagues that helped me to accomplish, let's say, this research topic editorial, work in frontiers, let's say during the June will be published also electronic book of the e-book will be published about this. I would like to thank all the both ministries that are providing money, but also GFE, PTB provides and agencies that are also providing money for my projects. Thank you for your attention, and I'm ready to take some questions.